For me, the field of nanotechnology was born on December 29, 1959, when Richard Feynman, in his visionary speech, "There's Plenty of Room at the Bottom," asked, what would happen if we could arrange the atoms one by one the way we want them? But there were some big hurdles to get over before we could answer that question, because we didn't have the tools to make, measure, or model things at the nanoscale. It took about 3 decades for these tools to catch up with Feynman's vision. But finally, in the 1990s, innovations such as scanning probe microscopy dramatically expanded our understanding and control of the nano world. But the tools were expensive, and the skills needed to make progress cut across many disciplines. And it became apparent that success would require a different, national scale approach to R&D. That new approach became the National Nanotechnology Initiative, announced by President Clinton in January 2000. So, after all this time, do we still need the NNI? For me, the answer is a resounding yes, because future breakthroughs will continue to transcend disciplines, and a national initiative is a proven strategy for breaking down barriers to collaboration. Nanotechnology R&D requires expensive infrastructure that's best shared. Paying for it grant by grant doesn't work. And lastly, other countries are working hard to advance the field and ultimately claim its benefits. Continuing the NNI will telegraph to the world that the U.S. means business when it comes to nanotechnology.